I thought that I was having a stroke. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome here if you are new. If you are new to my channel, please make sure that you subscribe down below. Today's video is gonna be kind of a wild one. I was trying to think of story times because I was like, okay, I've only really done like one story time video on my channel, which was my Italy disaster trip video. People seem to like it, so I was like, okay, I want to film another story time, but I don't really know what story to tell because I don't have these crazy stories. Like, I'm not Tana Mojo. I don't have these wild things that go on in my life. Like, I'm just, you know, a typical girl living in New England that doesn't have wild things happen to her. This was kind of a wild thing that happened to me, like, medically, and I wanted to share it. I have flown on a plane many, many times in my life. You know, the farthest I've gone is Italy. I've gone to, like, California, but mostly we fly to, like, Florida. I am very familiar with flying, and nothing like what I'm gonna tell you has ever happened to me on a flight before. My family, which includes my parents, my sister, her boyfriend, and then my best friend at the time, we were all going to Florida. We were going to Captiva Island, which is like literally my favorite place in the entire world. We're going to Captiva Island. This was our second time going. So basically the flight is from Boston, Massachusetts to Fort Myers. So, you know, it's like a 3-hour flight, typical Boston to Florida flight, super easy. So we're, you know, on the plane, we're going to Florida. So I do want to point something out that is going to be very important to this story because it's kind of the only thing that makes sense. I have had this, it's literally happening right now as I'm talking. I have this ear issue where in my left ear, it kind of gets blocked, like clogged. You know when you're sick and you get like a clogged ear, you have an ear infection and it's like, you can't really hear anything and it's really annoying because it literally is happening to me right now as I'm speaking. So I've had this issue since I was younger. I've been to multiple ear specialists in Boston, I think I went. I don't even remember now, but I'm pretty sure I went to Boston. To an ear specialist, they had no idea what it was. Nothing, like, they just don't know. It mostly comes on when it's like the winter time. Or when I have allergies or something. So it's just something weird that goes on in there. I know ways to get rid of it. Like, I can lay on my left side and like kind of lay there for a little bit and it goes away. I can swallow a certain way and it goes away. It's very odd, but it always kind of has been there and it always lingers with me. So anyway, I'm on this plane. We take off, everything is fine. I'm sitting there with my friend. We're just, you know, chilling on the plane. All of a sudden, we are up in the air, probably like full height. I don't know exactly how planes work, but we're probably at like the maximum level height because it was probably like an hour into the flight. So I'm assuming by that time you're probably, I don't know how it works, but you're probably pretty high up. All of a sudden, I feel that my left side of my face starts to feel a little tingly and weird. I'm like, okay, that's weird. And then very, very fast, my entire left side of my face went completely numb. I had no feeling in my left side of my face. My lips felt huge. When you know when you go to the dentist and you get Novocaine in your lips and you feel like they're huge and you feel like it's a, you're going like that and you got like 10 pounds lip injections. Yeah, that's what it felt like. So, but only the left side of my face. So the right side is just like, you know, active. I'm obviously freaking out. I start hysterically crying because I'm the type of girl that I get really, really nervous when something happens to me. Like, I could feel like an ache in my arm and I'm like, oh my god, I have bone cancer. I am freaking out. I'm not even sitting with my parents, so I have to, my friend has to switch seats with my mom, and I'm literally like, I don't know what's going on. My face is numb. Like, I thought that I was having a stroke. I've never had anything like this happen to me before, so I didn't know. And the first thing that comes to my head when you feel your face numb is you're having a stroke. So I'm like, okay, this is really great. So the flight attendants start coming over and I think that they gave me like a snack or something. I honestly don't remember. All I remember is them coming over and sitting, like, kneeling on the ground next to me, and I'm crying. I want to say they gave me water or a snack or something like that, but I cannot be sure. I mean, nobody really knows what to do. I'm on a plane, like, what am I supposed to do? I did start to think, okay, maybe this is related to my ear, because I know that I have ear issues, especially when I fly. It gets really bad. Like, when we go down, it, like, a lot of pressure, and it hurts really, really bad, and then I have to, like, pop it with my, you know. Anyway, I decide to just lay down on the little tray that comes out and put my head down and go to sleep, because that's really all I can do is just to go to sleep and not have to think about it, because I still had like 2 hours left on this plane, so I don't want to sit here and cry and be nervous. I wake up, face is still numb, we were about to start to go down. So we start to go down, like the plane starts to go down and get ready to land. My face slowly starts tingling and it slowly starts getting all its feeling back as we go down. So I'm like, okay, it's obviously the pressure. I'm really happy because my face is back to normal. I'm like, okay, I did not have a stroke, I don't think. Like something had to be, it had to be about the pressure, okay? Actually, I didn't even research it because I kind of felt like I diagnosed it on my own. A couple years later, when we were about to go to Italy, I started researching it because I was like, I don't want this to happen because the Italy flight is like 11 hours. This cannot happen. I look it up. It's actually normal. It is called unilateral facial paralysis. And it says, it turns out that this temporary facial numbness is actually due to pressurized buildup in the middle ear. Now I know that I was right about that, and now I know what to do to prevent it, and all that I have to do is take Tylenol, all I have to do is take Benadryl, which I thought was very odd, but it has worked every single time I've flown ever since. I wanted to make the story time because I'm like, maybe somebody else, this has happened to them and they haven't flown since because they're scared. Just know that it's normal. Well, at least if it's the same thing that I was having, it is normal. It's not very common, it says, but it is normal when it happens. And I understand that it's very scary and I was very scared. So if this has happened to you and you're scared to fly because of it, definitely just take Benadryl because that has helped me every single time and I've never had a problem since. Let me know in the comments if this has ever happened to you or somebody you know, because I've never heard this happened to anyone before. My sister actually had Bell's palsy in her face a couple years ago. Not like with flying, but she got Bell's palsy. And I think that this happened to me after it happened to her. So I kind of thought, okay, maybe it's that. I don't know if it was related to my ear problem. I have a feeling that it was because it did say that it's not very common. So, and it has to do with your ear. So I'm like, it probably had to do with the fact that my ear is all messed up. So that is my story time. I just wanted to make it because I thought it was kind of interesting and kind of a crazy thing that happened to me. Please make sure that you subscribe to my channel if you are not already subscribed. I have all my social media linked in my description box below. So if you want to follow me, if you want to DM me, if you want to talk, we can do that. Hope to see you in my next video. Hope that you have a great day or night, whatever time it is when you are watching this video. I'll see you next time. Bye.